สวัสดีครับ กสิทธิ์ พิรมยา once again this time I will say something about what has been happening in Malaysia our next door neighbor as everyone has known about the Supreme Court decision that decided to send the former Prime Minister of Malaysia Mr. Najib RazakTo a jail term of 12 years for embezzlement, for malpractices, for corruption, and so on, as a consequence of I think the misuse of the fund 1MDB, which was slated to be used for development of Malaysia as a whole, and to use that particular fund to invest in various economic activities in and around Malaysia, and so on.For the betterment of the Malaysian society, but somehow part of that fund was being siphoned off to a sister or affiliate companies, and that fund somehow returned back to Malaysia into the bank account of the former Prime Minister of Malaysia, Mr. Najib, and it has been quite a scandal and became a court case.Several years ago, until finally, on the 23rd of August, the Supreme Court had made a decision to send Mr. Najib to jail. It's a sad thing in a sense because for I think a very prominent Malaysian politician, and he is also a very prominent ASEAN politician and quite prominent among the Islamic world and so on.For the, I think, the policy of moderate Islam, you know, projecting Islam, Malaysia, Islamic things as a sort of in moderation and so on. And Mr. Najib was son of a former prime minister of Malaysia. And his political career started at a very early age of about 20 something.He was more or less, I think, appointed as a sort of a cabinet rank member in his 20s and so on. And he had risen through the rank of the UMNO major coalition party and through the ranks of political positions and so on, and became the prime minister of Malaysia in the year 2009. And he held that position for almost 10 years.So he became a very prominent and very powerful Malaysian political figure known all over the world and so on. But like everything else in life, I think the temptations sometimes were too strong. And I think he got involved in the development fund called the 1MDB fund, which was slated to be used for thedevelopment activities of the Malaysian society. The fund was to be used to invest in various activities inside Malaysia and abroad and so on. And the profit gain would be put into the use for the development of the well-being of the Malaysian people and society. But some of that money was being siphoned off and put into the personal banking account of Mr.Najib, and there were rumors and scandals about he has his own yacht, private jets, a lot of jewelry, properties, and so on. And finally, the whole thing came to the Court of Justice of Malaysia, and one was quite afraid that there would be a lot of political influence, that the court case would not move.And Mr. Najib would be, I think, let loose and so on because of his so much of immense political powers and popularity. But finally, on the 23rd of August, the Supreme Court of Malaysia did decide to give Mr. Najib a 12-year jail term. The Supreme Court, the chair of the Supreme Court of Malaysia is led by a well-known woman lawyer with high integrity. So in that sense, I think one has to, express our admiration for the integrity of the judges and the professionalism of the judges, and I think of the whole judicial system of Malaysia. It's very exemplary. The rule of law is the name of the game, and it has been put into effect positively. It's something that would be exemplary for developing countries, especially in Southeast Asia and in the Indian subcontinent and so on, that we can have, I think, if we tried a very, honest judicial system. And we can be a society with the rule of law. At the same time, one could also give some credit to Mr. Najib for the fact that throughout these court procedures, he remained in Malaysia. He did not come out with the excuses that the whole thing was politically motivated. And he did not take the chance of fleeing the country and seeking political asylum. He stood firm to fight the court case, and he had his chances and so on. And finally, a few days ago, he walked into the Malaysian prison. It's sad in a sense, but it's something that has to be, I think, a good example for all politicians, that at the end of the day, you don't run away and blame others. You take the consequences of your action and your responsibility in strife. And that, I think, would also provide a very good example and reminder to all politicians in Malaysia and outside and so on, that power is to be used to serve the people and the society. Power is not a means or a vehicle to amass wealth, personal gain, and so on. And things that belong to the society, the budget, the money, and so on, belong to the society. No politician can tamper with it, and so on. And I think with this happening and the court decision, we would like to wish that the Malaysian society move forward in a, I think, stronger, steady manner for the benefit of the Malaysian people, and I think by extension also for the benefit of ASEAN as a whole. Malaysia judicial system has showed its own true mantle of professionalism and integrity. The Malaysian politicians have accepted the rule of law, and this would be something that is to be emulated and admired by the rest of the ASEAN people and so on. And I think the Malaysian example could provide impetus for other members of the ASEAN community to move forward, and for the people in general to be encouraged that good things, rule of law, can exist amidst, you know, in our ASEAN society and so on. So once again, my deepest admiration to the Malaysian judicial system for professionalism and integrity. I'm a bit sad because I've known and met Mr. Najib many times, but I think he has accepted his fate, and hopefully that, I think, in his jail term, he could still have some reflection, and maybe he could give some thought that would be a guidance for the rest of us that aspire to be politicians, of the success and the shortcomings and so on, and the audacity to accept the consequences of one's doing. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ